What's up guys, it's Avery. Today we're finally gonna sit down and talk about some of my purchases from the past few months, mostly designer steals or thrift store finds. I'm finally back. It has been a few weeks since I've been here in my apartment, or more importantly, making a video for you guys. So thank you for your patience. I was working on doing some costume designing for a feature, which I'm really excited about, but that sort of took away from YouTube. Also, thank you to today's sponsor, ShopTagger, for really making this all possible, and I'm really excited to show you some steals that the service has also helped me find. I think we need to start off with shoes, because shoes are usually the biggest pickup. However, these were some of the cheapest and also some that I wear the most of, and I feel like a lot of you on social have started associating this shoe with me, finally. This is just a standard, beautiful Jack Purcell. I found these on eBay and just waited until they hit the right price. That is a huge thank you to ShopTagger. If you guys aren't familiar with the service, it allows you to save items you're looking at to your wish list. All you have to do is go to ShopTagger.com. It's a super simple process to add it to your Chrome toolbar. And then when you're shopping online, whether it's eBay or let's say like Essence, you can add stuff to your wish list and categorize it and choose when you want it to update you, if it drops a certain price, if it's back in stock. So I ended up getting these once they dropped in price for, I want to say $12 plus shipping. So 20 bucks to get these to me, and I wear them all the time. And even more exciting, ShopTagger and I are going to be giving away $100 to Todocayo, a gift card for you to spend on whatever you want. Just download ShopTagger, comment below, and I'm gonna pick one of you randomly. So perfect for right now around end of season sale time. I'll also link my blog down below where you can see my favorite end of season sales and also favorite items that are on my own personal ShopTagger wish list. So there you go. I love my black ones and love to skate in them. So this is a little bit more down to earth, earthy, natural look with this beige cotton canvas and that thick rubber wrapped toe cap. And this is just an iconic badminton shoe that also has pretty thick ties with the skate community. So super cool. I started skating all courts a long time ago, and those are just the perfect transition, and I think I might like them a little bit more. Now, a few really fun and exciting items came from Vanitas, which is a secondhand store based in Ghent, just outside of Antwerp in Belgium. And the owner of that shop is so sweet, and it's always so nice to talk about her. And she really knows her stuff and has awesome buys too. Or I guess awesome finds, I should say. This top I have been waiting to buy on her website for well over a year, probably longer. And I just wasn't sure how it would fit, but when I purchased something else, I figured I might as well, and it's awesome to support her. Anyway, this is a Leva Van Gorp top that has two t-shirts mangled together to create a new pattern. And of course, you probably know it, maybe from being a Jerry boy, maybe from being a Justin Bieber fan. This is that iconic Marilyn Manson tour t-shirt, which Jerry Lorenzo ripped and put it on Justin Bieber's tour merch, and very expensive tour merch at that. And usually when he does so, like let's say a Sonic Youth t-shirt, that shirt will be worth a few hundred dollars, which is crazy. And what's really cool about this is actually the vintage tour tee, but she was selling it at such a fair price, being the original t-shirt that's been reconstructed by such an interesting and underappreciated Belgian designer. Maybe not underappreciated, but just not as world-renowned as some of the Belgian designers of the early 90s when she was designing. And on top of it, on this beautiful sleeve here, this is perfect for Leva's story. This is dedicated to the one I love. She actually stopped pursuing clothing. She stopped being a fashion designer completely in order to dedicate her life to her partner and their research and campaigning for a very unique brain disease that her partner has. There's literally nothing to complain about, and shout out to Natalie. Love you. Thank you so much. Then I finally got a really good wallet. I've been on my card holder game for way too long, and this is a Margiela wallet that I'm super excited about from spring summer 2009. If you've had the pleasure of attending any Margiela exhibitions, you've probably noticed that in all the displays there's confetti everywhere, which is lovely, and this is confetti from a runway show that was then repurposed and adhesived on here with some sort of lacquered or some sort of laminate. So it's just a black leather wallet and a really nice patent outer with some good texture from some authentic confetti. Is there a such thing as fake confetti? I don't know. I also bought a Leva Van Gorp mug from Vanitas, which is super cool, but I'll show you that another day. This necklace right here I got direct from Japan for a steal when I was just doing one of my Japan proxy hauls. And this is an MM6 necklace, which is a diffusion line, but of course I don't like that negative connotation that comes with saying that. It is a recreation of some actual ice jewelry that was on a Margiela runway show, and now they turned it into a bracelet and a necklace, I think in 2014? I don't know, I'll fact check that. But I kind of want to replace this chain because it's much thicker than what was actually used in the ice utilizing runway show. And also it's not even silver, which kind of sucks, but it's a steal and it's super fun. And again, it reminds me, I said this about that De Moulemeester bracelet I used to have before it exploded. It reminds me of some Mapplethorpe jewelry or something like that. So that's a really fun one. Not super versatile, but I also think it's like the perfect amount of costume. Here is a pickup from Japan, actually, which I didn't really do much shopping when I was out there, but this is just a little liner that I found in a thrift store. I was amazed that all of the Americana vintage stores weren't that expensive. I figured it would be so highly regarded there, and the fact that you have to import it from the States means that it would be expensive, but it wasn't. I actually got this at a very normal thrift store for a few bucks. This is a classic field jacket liner that slips right into that 1965 US general issue field jacket. And I really liked it in Japan because it has almost a kimono fit because it's cut to be hidden underneath that jacket. And there's also some really, really cute hand tacked stitching where there's a hole on the back pit, which I really, really like. I have two pickups from Grailed that I want to show you. This is an Anarchy Forever, Forever Anarchy hoodie. It has this glitter print, red on red, that is just some random made in USA sportswear blank. United Sports, a really, really funny tag. They also put their own tags in here, and it also has a print on the side of the hood. AFFA is a collaborative project, was a collaborative project between Jun Takahashi and Hiroshi Fujiwara of Fragment, which is super cool. And it's just two legends in the Urahara scene, Japanese street culture, adopting Western values and making them way, way cooler. That's an awesome hoodie, and it has a really interesting fit. It's snug and small, but also kind of boxy at the same time. Does that make sense? I don't know. Then I have this dark shadow white cotton denim trucker. Not denim at all. I thought this was gonna be the same fabric as my air cuts because I thought it'd be hilarious to have both the tops and the bottoms, but it's actually much more of a lightweight cotton. Nonetheless, really pretty, and it's that same white that's gonna age really well. And if anything, it's a lot better for spring being this material. It's really nice. At first, I didn't think I was gonna get much wear out of it, but both Kaylee and I have been wearing this to death, which is killer. Always love to see. And the final item is this right here, which is this insane, oversized, boxy, look at that gorgeous red, black, and white plaid. I think I would have loved this in like 2013, 2014, but I have it now, years and years later. I got this at a garage sale in Rochester, trying to costume a specific character who's supposed to be a stoner and is supposed to wear a double XL. This is just an XL, but it fits huge, and it didn't actually end up being used in the film, but it's this thick, thick wool with a completely canvassed and quilted liner, which is super sick. it has that perfect balance of like Midwest hunting, but also skateboarder, or I don't even know what, but it's just, it's great, it's great. Thank you guys so much for watching. That is everything. I hope you enjoyed all of this. A lot of secondhand stuff, a lot of on sale stuff, which is super exciting. I guess I just haven't been buying any clothes. I haven't really talked much with you guys about Staatsballett and what we have been working on, but that's been a main focus of time and money and energy, and I just really haven't been shopping all too much. This is all probably from the past 6+ months. Who even knows? But nonetheless, appreciate you guys stopping through and hanging out. Look forward to talking with you in the comments. And until the next video, everyone do me one last favor. Have a good day. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.